Hi gamers, it's QuirkyPixel here. On this channel, I share tips, tutorials, and everything about the world of Animal Crossing New Horizons. So if you like Animal Crossing, then hit that subscribe button for new videos every week. I also live stream on Twitch if you want to come and see us play Animal Crossing New Horizons from release day. We're going to be playing it pretty much every day, or almost every day, and we're going to be sharing everything we learn and all the tips and stuff on this channel. By the time this video goes up onto YouTube, it's just going to be less than 20 days until Animal Crossing New Horizons releases. I thought it'd be a really good idea to share almost everything we know about Animal Crossing New Horizons so far. There's a lot of information on YouTube and from directs and also on Twitter. There's so much information about the new Animal Crossing game. So I thought, let's just make a video of like 100 facts about Animal Crossing New Horizons. So this is 100 things we know about Animal Crossing New Horizons so far. It's not everything, but 100 things is a lot of things. Number one, you start off on an island from scratch in a tent. So you're really living a island life in Animal Crossing. Number two, you can choose your map from a selection of 4 maps. When you first arrive on the island, Timmy and Tommy will greet you to show you 4 map options and you get to choose which map you would like. Number three, you can choose exactly where to place your house. Number four, you can choose exactly where to place villager houses. Number five, there is a handy grid to show you where the houses will be placed. So instead of just guessing where your houses and villagers' houses will go, you get to pick exactly where they will be placed. Number six, you can change your appearance in game instead of relying on a set of random questions. Number seven, there are more skin tones and hairstyle options, which makes the game more inclusive and gives you more options than the normal feminine and masculine styles of hair. Number eight, crafting is a big part of this game. There is a huge focus on crafting objects using materials that you can collect from around the game and also using materials that are usually in the game, such as fruit. Number nine, resources can be gathered for crafting. So there's a bunch of different resources from wood to clay that you can gather from around your island to use for crafting. Number 10, pine cones and acorns are now collectible materials. So these are new things that you can collect to use in your crafting. Number 11, you can craft fences to separate areas of your island. And there's a variety of fences. Number 12, there is a new feature called the Nook Phone. This has a bunch of Nook apps that you can use to do different things around your island. Number 13, Nook Miles is an application on this phone. You can do different tasks that will gain you Nook Mile points that you can spend. Number 14, you can use Nook Mile points to unlock special items in the game. Number 15, you can receive new titles for your passport from Nook Miles. Number 16, you can collect weeds instead of them disappearing, which can then be later used for crafting. Number 17, you can play together in local play with up to 4 players, including yourself. Number 18, you can play online with up to 8 players, including yourself. Number 19, New Horizon uses an auto-save feature, so there is no time travel. Number 20, the game seasons and time changes like in real life. So we have spring, summer, autumn, winter, and all the days are a different day in the year. Number 21, there is a southern and a northern hemisphere now. So if you live in the southern hemisphere, you can choose this option. So your seasons will correlate to the seasons that you normally have. And if you live in the northern hemisphere, you can choose this option. So your seasons will feel like they do where you live. Number 22, there is wind in the game. Number 23, hair and clothing blow in the wind. Number 24, shooting down presents from the sky with your slingshot will make a return. Number 25, you can place objects outdoors now. You can place them pretty much anywhere in your game. Number 26, there are shadows that cast from objects. Yes, the lighting is amazing in this game, and we even have shadows from objects. Number 27, the camera app is an application on the Nook Phone. Number 28, there is a mechanic where players will look at the camera when taking photos. Number 29, Rossetti Rescue Service is an application on the Nook Phone, which you can use if you ever get lost or stuck in the game to get placed in a location where you're no longer stuck. Number 30, There is a scroll wheel for tools for quick tool selection. Number 31, there's also a scroll wheel for quick emotion selection. Number 32, you can buy or learn recipes from crafting. Number 33, the transportation in this game is by airplane. Number 34, there are several colors of the seaplanes. Number 35, with 200 nook miles, you can explore uninhabited islands. Number 36, rain makes things look wet. Number 37, there's a larger beach than in past games. Number 38, when you plant flowers, they start out as saplings and grow as the days pass by. You could also pluck the flowers, leaving the stem, so they will possibly grow back. Number 39, weeds can grow in size if left unplucked. Number 40, when villagers move to your island, they will live in tents as well, and they will have to upgrade their houses to live in normal houses. Number 41, animal residents have conversations with each other. Number 42, there are multi-layer towns. You can have up to 3 layers in your town. Number 43, you can get a permit to terraform in your town. So you can add waterfalls, you can get rid of rivers and build rivers and also shape the whole of your town. You can shape the land in your town. Number 44, the fish and bugs have been redesigned with more detail and animations. Number 45, the animals in this game feel more alive. Number 46, villagers can be seen eating food. Number 47, inventory space is now upgradable from 20 slots to possibly 40 slots or more. Number 48, you can have more patterns that look smoother when placed in game. So not only do we have more slots for patterns, but when they are placed in game, they don't look as pixelated and they look smooth. Number 49, patterns can be made with transparent backgrounds. Yes, so we can finally have transparent backgrounds in the game, which is great for if we're designing flooring or even patterns for clothing. Number 50, you can place patterns on furniture. So this is a feature still again. We can place them on beds and couches and all these things. And also we can change the colors of the furniture, like the wood of the furniture as well. So much customization. Number 51, there are several color variants for clothing items now. One piece of clothing item will be in a variety of colors. Number 52, the museum will return and it looks better than ever. The new museum is beautiful, it's bigger, and it's insane, honestly. Number 53, blathers will start in a tent until you have enough items donated. So this is at least 15 items, it could be more. Number 54, there are 10 designs for creating pathways, and the 10th design is a custom design. These will be designs that you need to unlock in the game. Number 55, there is an aspect of danger in the game where scorpions, tarantulas, and bees will return. Number 56, as time moves on, more villagers can move to your island and you might be able to choose from 3 which one you would prefer. Number 57, you can craft an ocarina in the game and hold it up to your face to play it. Number 58, there are new items in the game such as mushroom furniture and other furniture sets and other special items that we have not seen before. Number 59, when you look through your Critopedia app, you get more information than ever before. You can figure out exactly when to catch this certain critter, and also you can see if it has been donated already. Number 60, you can make a flower crown from flowers. I'm so excited to make my first flower crown and also wear my flower crown while making flower crowns. This just sounds like a dream. Number 61, you can preview upgrades to your house. So instead of just adding a new item and not knowing what it's going to look like, you get to preview what it's going to look like before you even purchase it for your house. Number 62, walls and floor can be placed diagonally now, so we can place them in either horizontally or diagonally depending on how we are feeling. Number 63, when designing your room, you can rotate the room, rotate items, select multiple items at once and move those as well as you can check your storage, because each house has its own internal storage. Number 64, in the house, you can place items in storage without using the storage drawers. You can simply click on an item and place it in your storage, and you don't have to go through the hassle of picking up the item and then placing it in a wardrobe, for example. Number 65, when expanding the house, the windows don't disappear. They relocate to make room for extra hallways. This is amazing because our room in the center of our house is not gonna be dark and gloomy. Number 66, players can jump over narrow waterways. Number 67, there'll be a voting poll to jump over rivers and ponds that are wider than a single narrow waterway. Number 68, shops can be used to buy furniture items that you can't craft. So we still get to purchase furniture items that are things we can't actually craft in the game. Number 69, visitors will join you on your island for various items to buy and activities such as the bog-off and the fishing tourney. Number 70, the game will feature free updates for seasonal events. This is including Easter, Christmas, Halloween, and some other events. And because the seasons are coming as updates, this could change over the years and we could have different things that happen in our seasonal updates every single year. Number 71, there is a stepladder to climb up small cliffs. So until you have a staircase or a ramp, you can use your stepladder for easy access. Number 72, we now have access to ramps and staircases, and there's a variety of designs we can choose from. Number 73, items such as fossils and fish tanks can be placed outside, which make great displays, but also it's a great way to store them until we get that museum. Number 74, there are a few new villages we haven't seen before in this game. There are actually three villages that we get to see at a birthday party in the Nintendo Direct. So these are just a preview of the new villages that we're gonna have. Number 75, New Horizons has amiibo support, which means that we can bring characters into the game using amiibo, and then they could probably move into the campsite, and then we can ask them to move into our island. Number 76, Phototopia is a brand new feature where you can create sets and take photos of your favorite villagers. Number 77, in party play, one person is appointed to the leader, so everyone stays on screen together. Number 78, the other players will be able to follow us and we will be able to switch out the leader, which means that each person gets their turn in deciding what the other players do. Number 79, anything collected during party play will be stored in the recycle box where players can claim what is theirs. Number 80, Nooklyn can be used to scan QR codes from other games such as New Leaf and Happy Home Designer, so all is not lost. Number 81, online players can use the New Horizons phone app to speak in the game using chat bubbles, or there's also a voice chat. Number 82, within the app you can choose best friends who have special privileges on the island. Number 83, there is a safety feature online to only let best friends use tools like the axe and shovel so they do not destroy your town. Number 84, houses can be designed in a multitude of ways. There's so many different design variations for your houses now. Number 85, some villagers may wander onto your island and you can ask them to move in. Number 86, looks like you can water multiple flowers at once. Number 87, villagers and player characters can be seen sitting on furniture together. Number 88, we can see villagers participate in activities such as fishing too. Number 89, it seems your town flag appears at the airport. Number 90, snowmen are back. We now can create snowmen in winter again. Number 91, villagers will wear warmer clothes in the winter and lighter clothes in the summer. Yes, our villagers now change their clothes depending on the weather. Number 92, the sky during the winter showcases the northern lights. Number 93, when shaking Christmas trees in the winter, sometimes baubles will fall off them. Number 94, there are cherry blossoms in spring. Number 95, there are piles of leaves and petals in the game. Number 96, the sunsets in the game seems to come in a variety of colors. Number 97, resident services plan to expand. Once this expands, you have the option to expand your house, customize your house, and also you can relocate your house at any point in the game. Number 98, you can even relocate shops too. Number 99, Isabel will return to help with resident services. And finally, number 100, the message in the bottle feature will return. Okay, that is 100 things we know about Animal Crossing New Horizons so far. I'm super excited. I honestly don't want to find out any new information. I just want to jump in the game and I want to discover it for myself. I can't wait to start a brand new island life in Animal Crossing New Horizons. And I just want to discover the game and everything it has to offer, all the little details and all the features. I just want to live this game. I don't want any more information from anyone else. I might even just stop watching other people's videos on this for a little bit. Let me know in the comments which feature, which thing you're most excited for in Animal Crossing New Horizons. I am most excited for the fact that you can customize pretty much everything in the game. There's so much customization. That is the thing I'm most excited for and cannot wait to try out. I'm gonna put so much time and effort into designing my town in this game. If you like this video, then let me know by giving it a thumbs up and leaving a comment down below. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to keep on creating and following your passions. I'll see you very soon with another Animal Crossing video.